Hello everyone, and welcome to our video on analyzing risk in Microsoft Entra Identity Protection. My name is Winston, and I am the Identity Protection Engineering Architect.
Hi, my name is Marilee, and I'm the Senior Product Manager on the Identity and Network Access team.
Hi, my name is Gargi, and I'm also a Senior Product Manager in the Identity and Network Access team at Microsoft. Today, we will be discussing why organizations should configure risk-based conditional access. We will see how it can help reduce workloads for security operation centers and lower support overhead. We will also walk you through three specific steps for analyzing risk using Azure Monitor log reference tables for identity protection. And we will demonstrate how both custom conditional access policies and Microsoft managed policies can be used effectively to protect your tenant.
Thank you, Gargi. Conditional access involves a customizable set of rules that determine whether users can access corporate resources based on factors such as device platform, geographic location, device state, and other contextual signals. Risk-based conditional access is a powerful tool that can automatically remediate risk by assigning each sign-in and each user a likelihood of being compromised. Levels are labeled as no risk, low risk, medium risk, or high risk. This categorization significantly reduces workloads for security operations centers and support teams. We've seen cases where customers were able to address password compromises and other security threats before their IT departments even got involved. This proactive approach is critical when you consider the scale of damage that can result from security incidents that slip through the cracks. This is especially true now that cyber attacks are evolving and becoming more advanced than ever.
That's right, Marilee. With over 300 billion human and machine identities in play, the stakes are even higher every day. In 2024, the time it took for attackers to access sensitive data after a phishing click dropped from over an hour to under 60 seconds. Password spray attacks now exceed 7,000 per second globally, and token thefts are up 111% in just 1 year. With the average data breach now costing $4.9 million and ransomware incidents averaging even higher, implementing comprehensive identity monitoring and risk-based conditional access represents a critical investment in preventing these catastrophic security failures that can shut down operations and expose millions of customers' sensitive data. It's more important than ever to secure your tenants' rights. We have found that premium P2 tenants who use risk-based conditional access remediate user risk 140 times faster than P2 tenants who don't use risk-based conditional access.
Absolutely, Gargi and Marilee. This is exactly why we're consistently building new risk detections to address this evolving security landscape. Now, let's dive into the steps for analyzing risk so we can address these threats. In Azure Monitor, we have four risk event tables that we can use to query user and sign-in risk in Microsoft Entra Identity Protection. They are AADUserRiskEvents, AADRiskyUsers, AADServicePrincipalRiskEvents, and AADRiskyServicePrinciples. Today, we will focus on the AADUserRiskEvents table. Our queries hub includes pre-built queries that you can leverage for common scenarios in your tenant. We built these tables to help customers understand risk trends in their tenants, and we've spoken to many customers who were able to discover serious true positive threats and implement changes based off their findings from these queries. To isolate risk and understand what's generating the most risk in your tenant, you'll want to leverage the AAD user risk event table and summarize the count by user display name. If you add the detection timing type column to this query, you can see which events would affect real-time sign-in risk and conditional access policies. This is where you'll identify common patterns among users, such as service accounts, or small subsets of users generating a large amount of risk for a tenant. Here you can see we have several risky users, but one user is really generating the most risk. If this account represents true positives, you may want to choose to block them or require secure password changes. You may want to create a conditional access policy to specifically exclude these high-risk users when granting access to resources. Next, let's dive into our second step for analyzing risk. After we've looked at patterns for specific users, we next want to look at the detections themselves and summarize them by detection type, using the AAD user risk event table and summarizing these by the risk event types. You'll want to pay attention to large volumes of certain types of detections. Here you can see that there are several risk events being flagged. Most of them, though, are related to unfamiliar features, anomalous token, and unlikely travel. If you're seeing unfamiliar features detections, this means there are a lot of unfamiliar sign-in properties showing up for that user. So you may want to enforce session controls such as sign-in frequency, application restrictions, and persistent browser controls. If you're seeing anomalous token detections, you may want to set up conditional access policies to require password reset or block access for all high-risk sign-ins. And if you're seeing a lot of unlikely travel detections, but you have a lot of legitimate users in your tenant who are traveling, we recommend adding name locations as trusted IPs to customize your risk signals and ensure that trusted locations are not being flagged as risky. Also, it's good to check if a customer is using a proxy that might be skewing the location data. You can use summaries from the AAD User Risk Event query to understand risk event trends in your tenant and then construct conditional access policies to best assess and fit these risks.
Thank you, Winston. This leads us to our third step for analyzing risk and addressing risk signals. After we've looked at the user behavior and the risk event types, the next step we recommend is to examine the AAD User Risk Events table again to look at the three risk levels, low, medium, and high. Run the Kusto query to summarize the count of risk events by risk level and analyze the total numbers of each risk level. Here, for example, you can see that we have many total detections firing in our tenant, but only six of these are high-risk detections. So you want to focus on those few high-risk detections and address those first. Having this summarized data makes it easy to prioritize risk signals and construct your conditional access policies. Our high-risk detections are very accurate, so we recommend, at a minimum, having a baseline conditional access policy in place to either require a secure password change or outright block those high-risk users. We've spoken with several customers who were uncertain about whether this risk data would provide value, but as soon as they ran this Kusto query to filter by high risk, they were able to identify real token theft, leaked credentials, and password spray detections. Just by performing this quick check and then configuring risk-based conditional access policies, many customers have prevented serious security incidents from occurring in their organizations. Again, you'll want to consider the risk level trends holistically alongside the specific user trends and risk event types that Winston just showed.
Just to summarize everything we've just showed for investigating risk, you want to first look at the user display names to see who's really generating those risk events, and then filter by risk event types to try and understand common risk event trends in your tenant. And lastly, look at the risk level itself to see the count of low, medium, and high detections. You can join these tables together to understand trends and get a comprehensive view of which users are generating the most risk, which risk event types are the most common for those users, and how many total high-risk detections are firing. Then you can customize your conditional access policies to address these risks.
Thank you, Marilee and Winston. It's worth underscoring that Microsoft Entra Identity Protection policies are flexible and can be customized to account for different risk behavior and variations in tenants. Conditional access enables you to allow or block access to resources based on signals such as user, device, and location. In addition to configurable conditional access policies, we have also introduced new Microsoft Managed policies to simplify this configuration further. By using Microsoft's baseline recommendations, you can effectively manage sign-in risk and ensure your organization's security policies are up to date. You can see here in the portal, we have a built-in Microsoft Managed policy that requires multi-factor authentication for risky sign-ins. Enabling this policy is a great way to enhance your tenant's security posture, since recent studies have found that by enforcing MFA, you can reduce the risk of compromise in your organization by 99%. You can apply Microsoft Managed policies out of the box or edit them to exclude users, groups, or roles. The policies are intended to simplify configuration and security for organizations by adding baseline MFA enforcement. You can also mix and match custom conditional access policies with these Microsoft recommended policies to apply even more granular controls.
We hope this video has helped you understand the importance of risk-based conditional access and how to analyze and manage risk within your organization.
We are constantly releasing new detections and new ways to proactively safeguard against risk in your tenant. Don't forget to visit our blog at techcommunity.microsoft.com to see the latest updates. You can also read more about our diagnostic settings at aka.ms/IDP diagnostic settings.
Be sure to check out aka.ms/IDProtect for more Microsoft Entra Identity Protection videos. Thanks for watching.